Boutier fight the terrific air currents of the rarefied desert atmosphere 2,300 feet above sea level as J.D. Pate attempts to step from the speeding plane to the top of the Essex counterplate. Well, the air's pretty bumpy up there. He's going to make it. No, he misses. No contact that time. Let's try again. You know, a stunt like this is just a matter of perfect coordination, and Pate is bound and determined that he's going to make it. Well, the plane's drifting in. Pilot jockeys for position. Closer, closer. They're coming in at 70 miles an hour. And boy, look how close to the sands the wheels of that plane go. All right, here he comes. Going, whoops. Uh-oh, not quite. Just a sudden gust of wind, that's all, that lifted the plane high into the air. Pate's arms are so exhausted that to keep from falling, he grips the wing of the plane with his teeth. But they say the third time is the charm. Let's see if it is. Yes, sir, it is. And good boy, Pate, you made it. Here's a close-up of that same shot. Boy, that was a close one. Just a close shave and also a haircut if you want it. Let's take a look at the construction of the landing platform. There's Pate just as calm and serene as though aquaplaning. And so the speeding wheels of this great Essex have made possible another successful and unequaled terraplane thriller.